Hello and welcome to episode 23 of the Bitcoin Show. We're just racking them up. It's like a slot machine. Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah.
Another episode. Oh my gosh. We skipped one yesterday because we have one tonight. I'm Bruce Wagner.
This is Manny Mena.
And today our special guest is from, you have heard of it. You may not have seen him or heard of him, but bitbills.com. Doug, welcome.
Thank you.
So tell us, well, first of all, we got to thank our sponsors. I'm sorry. I always forget. But we can't forget our sponsors. We want you guys to contact them and thank them for bringing us to you every day. Mezzi Grill is the world's first restaurant, brick-and-mortar restaurant, that accepts Bitcoin. And they have the most amazing Mediterranean food. They're now serving breakfast. We eat there 3 times a week. We love Marwan. Go in and see MezziGrill.com, MezziGrill.com. You can check out their menu. It's very wholesome and healthy and organic as possible and all that jazz, and very affordable for Manhattan. So if you live in New York or you're traveling through New York, don't miss going to Mezzi Grill and buying lunch with Bitcoin, or breakfast or dinner. And CarpeVM, CarpeVM.com. Seize your market, say it with video. They will help you create a video marketing campaign for your website that sells the product or service that you want to market and make you look like a pro. They'll really help you sell whatever it is you're selling with video for your website. And usgoldcoins.com, 1-800-HOT-COIN, that's Andy Gauss. Andrew Gauss is a monetary historian, he calls himself, but he's an absolute expert in all things money. And he's my money guru. He's been our money guru for years. And actually, I proudly introduced him to Bitcoin, and now he's like all about Bitcoin too. But if you want to diversify your experts, there's nobody more knowledgeable and trustworthy than Andy Gauss, which is usgoldcoins.com, 1-800-HOT-COIN. Just ask for Andy and he will talk with you. He's very accessible and brilliant. He's got a big company, but he'll take your call. And tradehill.com, of course. Tradehill, the newest exchange on the block, and they have so many easy ways to get money in and out. All sorts of new innovative features and ideas. They now have the two-part authentication. Yep. And it's free. It's brilliant.
That's what we covered in our last show.
Exactly. That's what we just did. And there, you can get a 10% off all your trade fees for life if you use the Bitcoin Show's referral code TH-R141. We thank TradeHill.com for their support. And Mt. Gox, MTGOX.com. Who doesn't know? Anybody who knows about Bitcoin knows about Mt. Gox because they've been around since the beginning. Mt. Gox is the oldest and largest exchange. They have the market share for sure. And they've had their challenges, but they've shown their resiliency. They're not going anywhere. They could have packed up, lesser people might have packed up and taken the Bitcoins and run, but they didn't. They're here for the long term. They've improved their technology and their security, and they're still here. So obviously they're a trusted member of the community. We thank them for their support as well. So Doug, Bitbills. Tell us, first of all, for those people in the audience who don't know, what is a Bitbill?
Absolutely. So Bitbills are a way to hold Bitcoins. You know, Bitcoins are really great for you for using and spending Bitcoins. They're a great way of spending money online. And whenever you're on your computer, it's kind of the most secure way and the easiest and the cheapest way to send money online. But the second you lose your internet connection or you go offline, you can't use them. Right. So at Bitbills, what we've done is taken the private key, which is sort of the meat behind the Bitcoin, and encoded it in a QR code, and then it's embedded inside of this card. So this can be handed off from person to person and used just like cash, but it's really a Bitcoin.
So the private, basically the private key is the secret part of the Bitcoin. That's like the password that unlocks the actual value, the spendability.
Yeah, it's what allows you to sign off a new owner to the Bitcoin. So then the Bitcoin network knows to only accept Bitcoins from that new owner.
Okay, and that's inside this secret seal. Oops. Yep. So they're actually denominated. These are denominated as what? One Bitcoin, 1, 5, 10, 20.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. So the idea is that you could actually buy Bitcoins and store them this way, and you could also transact this way. If you were willing to accept Bitcoins, I could just say, here's a Bitcoin.
Exactly.
Okay, so it's a physical implementation.
So these are set values, and when you buy these on our site, you'd pay 5 Bitcoins for a 5 Bitcoin card plus a small fee, and then for the life of this card, it'll always be worth 5 Bitcoins until it's eventually redeemed.
Mm-hmm. The card doesn't tell me how much a Bitcoin is worth, but we have to figure that out ourselves. But the private key, I see it's sealed under a safety seal and all that. Is there any way to read through that or to
absolutely not? So we've actually had X-rays made of these cards, and there's no way to read the QR code without actually cracking open the card. And when you do that, obviously you destroy the cards.
Oh, wow. What about an MRI?
Next, we X-rays first, then MRIs. Maybe next.
Okay.
That's interesting that you would even go that extra step to verify that.
Yeah, so well, a lot of people we know, we thought maybe a bright light or something, but a lot of people thought, oh no, we got to do X-rays. So we tried the X-rays, couldn't do it.
That's pretty awesome. And what did he do? You did that at a doctor's office or something?
No, we knew an expert in the field, so we had him do it. And
that's awesome.
I would have waited till I went to my dentist and I had to have a checkup anyways. Can you X-ray this real quick or pull it in my mouth?
We actually have some great pictures of it, so they'll be on our website within a couple of weeks.
That'd be awesome. I think people would like to check that out, and that also build confidence in, you know, the actual bid bill.
I mean, there's not much to see because you can't see it.
You can't see it. But, you know, we've talked before, Doug and I, and I was really impressed with, you know, I mean, I understand the concept and the idea, but what you don't really go into, like when you have a hot dog, you don't really think about how it's manufactured. Mm-hmm. So the factory, basically, the concept of how these are manufactured, that so much care has to go into it, because if there's the slightest mistake, as you pointed out, like if you were manufacturing them and somehow they got out of sequence, mm-hmm. the private key for this card applied to the actual public key of this card and they got out of skew somehow, then someone would actually, if I redeemed my card, I'd actually be redeeming your value, which could be disastrous.
That would be.
Super high security product. So that you triple check everything, you personally oversee all of the private keys and how they're manufactured, right?
Right, yeah. The key to it really is just testing. We push these through in batches, and in every batch, we figure out, is there a way that we can test and make sure that everything is exactly what it's supposed to be? Mm-hmm. And so that happens at least 5 times before the card's out of our doors.
And so you're testing the public key and the private key, that they match and that the value's there and all those things.
Yeah, exactly. Wow. And it's easy to check, fortunately. So. Yeah. It's really bad if we make a mistake, but it's easy enough to check that we keep it secure.
That's good. And then for the actual bit bills, is there like error tolerance built in so that maybe if they want to redeem it like 5 years later and, you know, there's some wear and tear on the card, they'll still be able to read it?
No, these should be durable for much more than 5 years, and definitely no problem if it gets damaged a little bit. There's error tolerance built into the QR code.
Okay.
And then it's also completely laminated and waterproof and sealed. So
awesome.
There's really no way.
To actually remove this sticker.
It's definitely waterproof, yeah.
And how would you remove the sticker if you had to? You don't have to show us, but...
So just to give a little more explanation, if you haven't read the details on our website, there's a few layers to the card. So there's this substrate in the middle, which is sort of the blank that has the design and then also the address QR code. Mm-hmm. And then on top of that is the square private key QR code.
Yep.
And that's separately laminated. So it's a very, very durable process just inside of that square itself, you know, regardless of the card. Then on top of that goes the security hologram, which obviously blocks the face of the QR code. And then finally, the whole card is laminated separately. And so it comes out as this really nice hard plastic card, but really... there's a few layers here, and so when you go to redeem it, you cut it open, and the layers all come apart, and you're left with just the QR code that you can go to redeem.
Interesting. So that's a great concept.
If you carried it around in your wallet, like I carry cards around in my wallet till they just disintegrate. But if you literally carried it around, and you know it got all bent up and everything, it wouldn't damage it. Until if you actually broke it or cut it, then the layers would just fall apart. But you'd still be able to.
In fact, if you have scissors, I'd be happy to cut one open.
Really?
We'll
grab some scissors.
you're welcome to play with it before. This is cut to signify that that this one's invalidated. But
is there a fortune inside, like a fortune cookie? I want to see what the estimated price of a Bitcoin is by the time you open it. That would be interesting. So. Let's see, what else? How did you figure out the manufacturing process that you've come up with?
Let's see.
I know you guys are, here, I'll let you do it.
Yeah, I'm not going to use, we actually, these ones, we have designated ones that we use for testing, so this one included, and you can try, before we break it open, you can try flexing it, These are actually more durable. There's a few different card technologies out there. Mm-hmm. A big one is PVC. That's what like your credit card is. And mm-hmm. this process is actually more durable than those cards. So
yeah, I was noticing that usually a credit card would bend and you could see visible creases in there.
That's right. Yeah.
And with this, you can't see any of that.
This will, you know,
I'm gonna really try to bend it. Okay. Oh wow.
Go ahead.
That is crazy. On a card, you would see like it's starting to deform and
right. You just go like 10 times and you've got two cards.
Exactly.
Oh wow.
And yeah, you can make this ugly, but it'll stay intact.
That is crazy. There you go.
Let me try. I want to. Oops. I can make it into a slingshot. Let's see. So I can bend and bend and bend. I can see what you mean. It's more durable because it's got the multiple layers.
That's right. Yeah.
It's not just one piece of material that will weaken. Wow.
Right.
I think I could break that with my hands. It would take a long time and a lot of bending.
That's right. So when you are ready to redeem it and you do want to break it open, you just take a pair of scissors. And again, these aren't made to be redeemed instantly. These are supposed to be durable cards that can be stored, and you can keep your Bitcoin safe and trade with them mm-hmm. if you like. But they do eventually come to somebody who wants to redeem them. So I'll try to show the camera here.
Once a Bitcoin is worth $10,000. Want to buy a car with that one Bitcoin.
That's right. And of course, even if you want digital Bitcoins, we accept them. If you have a lot of them, you can just mail them to us and we'll send you digital Bitcoins. And you'll that way you don't even have to bother cutting this open.
You have special people with scissors that just do this.
Well, they have resale value because a lot of people have digital Bitcoins, but they want Bitbills. So
you sell
even
used Bitcoins?
So you basically exchange it for somebody that wants that same denomination. Yeah. You send them those. That's
right.
Awesome.
Obviously, we sell the new ones, all have a small fee on them, mm-hmm. but we take the used ones and we don't even have to cut them open because there's always somebody who thinks it's a great deal to get it for face value.
Oh.
So I've cut this open now and it's in a few layers. So I'm peeling this apart. And this square now, inside of here, is the private key QR code.
Wow, let me see.
It just still has the hologram on it, but other than that, that's it.
So if I peel off the hologram and I hold it up to the camera, then the first one to claim it will get a Bitcoin?
So this one not. This is one of the testing ones, so it's
there's
been
no
validated.
Value in it?
Not this one.
Oh.
And that's in fact why it's marked with this cut through it and this cut through the hologram.
Can I get the seal off? Is it hard to do?
No, go ahead.
I don't know. I don't have nails. See if you can do it.
Sure. And
you have to have fingernails and scissors.
That's right.
It's like a do-it-yourself.
This comes off.
It's amazing. As high tech as Bitcoin is, we go so low tech to get it down into the physical material.
Yeah.
Just for the. I mean, it's amazing how.
That's how people gravitate. Yeah.
Yeah. Like when we have meetings and we have notepads and paper because there's no better way to take notes.
That's right. And I've gotten half the hologram off, and you can see the QR code underneath there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then with a little more work, you know, you can take the whole thing off, put it in front of a.
By peeling it off, you can't damage the. The QR code? Like, it's not...
No, it's... That's...
Look at that.
That's hollow...
What is that material made of?
Laminated
that
underneath there.
Is this PVC? The card?
No, it's not. It's a special plastic substrate that when it is with the plastic, it's got its micro pores.
Cool.
So the plastic actually goes into the pores and forms one solid plastic chip, essentially, that has that QR code on it.
Wow, this is awesome.
So you're an MIT genius, right?
I don't know, but that's...
A modest...
maybe he's
you
Satoshi.
Graduate, you're an MIT graduate?
That's right. I go to school at MIT, and that's where I live for most of the year.
Oh,
so.
cool.
But yeah, and I'm working on Bitbills is mostly out of Cambridge, out of Boston. So
it should be your thesis, right? Since it's already done. That's fantastic.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, there have been other projects that you can print a public or private key and things like that,
mm-hmm.
but to obscure it in a really effective way that's immune to damage and even mm-hmm. water. You could go scuba diving with these things in your pocket and not worry about it.
And even though there's all this awesome technology in it, kind of the coolest thing about it is just like when you tell it to somebody who doesn't understand the technology and they can mm-hmm. hold it and they just know that like this is a Bitcoin and
physical.
It's worth one Bitcoin and they can go online and see what it's worth in dollars and they know that that's what it is.
This is huge, especially right now because there's so much concern with security, you know, mm-hmm. and how do I store my Bitcoins?
Right.
You know, the thing is that these are wonderful for trading and for small amounts and introducing people to Bitcoins over brunch. Mm-hmm. You can say, here's $20, here's a Bitcoin,
yeah.
you know,
yeah.
here you go, that's a Bitcoin, it's a physical Bitcoin. So But the problem is there are some people who were early adopters who now have like a significant amount of money in Bitcoin form, and they don't, you know, whatever, say they have 1,000 Bitcoins or 10,000 Bitcoins or whatever, they don't want 10,000 cards.
Right.
You're not going to ship them a whole box full of 10,000 cards. That's not really practical. So, have you got a solution for that?
Yeah, absolutely. So,
how's that for a segue?
We announced it just this week, and it's something we've been working on a long time. We really wanted to get it right. But what we have, we're calling it a bank card. And this is just a prototype. The final design is a little bit different. And this is made out of metal. So as durable as these are, made out of plastic, and with the sealed hologram, these are metal, so this would withstand fire, which is pretty cool.
Is there a way that I can show that up to the camera?
Yeah, I'm sure
nobody will...
So with this has the public key and the private key on it. And this QR code is visible. This one doesn't have a balance on it, so don't bother trying to redeem it.
Yeah, I'll show it to people.
Camera one over there.
You buy this from us on our website. And it,
that's not going to focus. It's try like this a vault. Camera over here.
Yeah.
So you have a good view. So this is kind of like a vault that you can use to keep your Bitcoins in.
So that's
you buy this
the
and it has
idea,
no balance on it, but you can then add Bitcoins to it by sending them to the address. And as long as you keep that card in a safe spot, like in your house or a safety deposit box maybe,
it's such a brilliant idea. So the private key on this is not obscured, so you definitely don't carry it around and show people.
Right.
Because anybody with a camera phone could go, boop, and I just took your value.
That's right.
I could, just with a photo, I could snap your value out of it. But so you have to keep it hidden. Mm-hmm. You put it inside of an envelope.
That's right. It's
like
gonna cash. It comes with a sticker and an envelope, so even if you are walking around with it, it's, you know.
And so you put it in your safety deposit box or bury it in a box in your backyard, whatever you would normally do with a box full of cash.
Right.
But or a bar of gold or something. Mm-hmm. But the idea then is that then you can keep, you have another, it comes with another card that has only the public address.
That's right.
So you can keep that in your address book, in your normal Bitcoin app or whatever. And then if you want to put half your paycheck into Bitcoin every week, like one of our guys does, you can literally just send Bitcoins to that address without ever taking the card out of the safety deposit box or digging it up from the backyard or whatever.
Exactly,
just send it to that address and you're done. Mm-hmm. Like magic.
That's right.
And I know you call it a bank card.
Right.
When I first read that, I was like, bank card? I immediately thought of a credit card. I thought, what?
It's more like a deposit.
I think of it, so I'm going to call it a piggy bank card.
it's actually very much like a piggy bank.
Because it's like a piggy bank with a slot that you can, but the slot is detachable. So you can take the slot and leave it on your computer and then bury the bank, and it's actually like magically connected, right?
That's right. But everything, we like to think that everything you might have needed a big bank for before to have a vault that you keep dollars in, it's now in a card, you know?
It is a bank.
You can put as much money as you want on it and then go and redeem it all at once
it's
without any hassle.
It's a personal bank.
Yeah, your own personal
created
bank.
Created by you.
But you can't spend the money out of it unless you have the private key. So if
Until you redeem it.
It's like a savings plan, because it's perfect for a savings plan, because like I said, you just keep depositing. Uh-huh. But as soon as you want to make a withdrawal,
right,
it's okay, I'm really hard up, I need some money, or I decided I finally have enough to buy that yacht or whatever. Then you just take the card out, and then how do you redeem it with the private key then?
Sure. So you can scan the QR code in, and right now there's a client built by SIPA, who's a community member that'll take the QR code. And now there's also an even easier thing. It's a Python tool that it's a little program that you run, and it just puts the coins right in your wallet from the QR code.
Okay, so it's for the lay people, you say there's a client, so you mean there's an app?
Yeah, exactly. It's a program, just like the Bitcoin program you run on your computer, and but it's a little different version that you can hold this up to it, and it'll take the QR code. And
where's the safest place to get that app? Because it has to be a safe source. You don't just download any old app, because the app itself could be a virus that's designed to steal your money.
Yeah.
So you got to make sure it's a very
When we're talking about redemption, let's back up. So for these guys too, it's the same exact process. It's a private key, and then actually we're working on a tool that'll be on our website, and it should be up by the end of the week or by Monday, where you can just hold it up to your webcam and it scans it in, and you'll have them instantly at an address that you type in. You know, you do one, and you can make sure that it goes in, and everything's in your address book, and it's all secured. It's we use industry grade server protection, so. There's also no money stored on the server. It's all a transaction that goes through right away. It's not like Mt. Gox where
it's not an artificial ledger. It's really just a transaction that gets encoded and put right out into the blockchain.
Right.
Oh my god.
And so you could use the same tool that's on our website for redeeming these, Mm-hmm. But if you want to do it offline, which is also a great option, you can use one of these other clients, and they're signed and they're by reputable community members. You can read them the source code.
But for an absolute total novice, the safest way, or one safe way, would be just to go to bitbills.com.
That's right.
There's an you can click a link there, and it'll launch the viewer for their webcam, and they can just hold it up the webcam. Is there any way that an app, like some sort of man in the middle attack or something, some sort of virus could capture the image off?
No,
the
so it's actually completely encrypted, end to end.
Oh.
So it's we've worked really hard on this. In fact, we announced it a couple months ago, uh-huh. or a month and a half ago, and we've been still working on it because we just want to make sure we get security absolutely tight and locked down.
This is brilliant. Yeah.
You know, it's on your computer, so you obviously you're going to make sure your computer is free from viruses, standard precautions, and then
absolutely.
Once you scan it in, it gets encrypted. And then it gets sent over the internet, and so even if somebody were to intercept it on the internet, they can't decrypt it until it gets to us. It's encrypted using our public key, and then we decrypt it, transact the bitcoins right away to your account, and so
that's brilliant.
There's no more liability.
I told you he's an MIT genius, and who wouldn't trust this guy? I mean, that's just so smart. It's absolutely so smart. It's exactly what people need because, you know, we're making a video to teach people how to, which we've talked about because you helped me with the
recipe.
It's
a big problem.
Yeah, I mean, people need a way to secure their bitcoins without necessarily trusting some guy on the cloud, and you know, we don't even know. We don't even know their real names or whatever. Mm-hmm. You know, these people.
Yeah.
So, you really want to trust them. You want to really trust yourself.
Yeah, and encrypting is a smart step. Because imagine all the people that do any sort of transactions in internet cafes, and then anybody who has even a little bit of knowledge could just snoop in on that traffic and then, you know, capture the private key.
Absolutely. So everything's encrypted. It's
That's brilliant. Protected. So basically with the bank card, I mean, the denominated cards are great for introducing friends and family and gifts. I can imagine stocking stuffers. Right. I mean, a million
definitely for
ideas.
Trade, you want to use this because it has the value marked.
Right, of course.
It's trusted.
It's the value marked, and also it's it's more secured, the private key, because this is just going to be a sticker on this one. So this is specifically designed to hold, and it's not going to have the private key on the front like that, is it?
No, it does.
It
has both a text version of the private key and a QR version.
But it'll be sealed. So
but yeah, both
it.
Both will have stickers over them.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And
great.
It's also in an envelope. So. Yeah.
So that's brilliant. It's just like, oh my gosh, it's a pass card to your savings. Mm-hmm. Would you recommend that people have multiple versions of this to not put them all into one?
So
just in case?
There is a not just in case. They're all going to be just as secure. And you can even check that. You know, it's 100% secure. The reason you want to have multiple, though, is because you have to redeem them all at once. Mm-hmm. And the security, once you get that online, it's now online again. So it's just not as secure as when it's completely offline. So this way, what you can do is keep, you know, maybe your backup savings on one that you never redeem. But then for day-to-day purposes, you deposit to one that you maybe cash out when it's time to pay the rent.
Right.
Or something like that. So
you get multiple savings accounts in different denominations. Because these are denominations of, you know, 1, 5, 10, 20, and that's great. Mm-hmm. But if Bitcoin becomes worth $1,000, God knows what could happen.
Well, we're adjusting. We have a 0.5 Bitcoin card that's coming out very soon.
You're going to have to adjust fast if the price keeps changing. But if it does, then what's going to happen is those are going to be like huge amounts, and you're going to have to adjust down and all that. Yeah. But with this, you can actually have multiple. Maybe you should sell them in different colors. That'd be kind of cool.
We do. Actually, we have different colors, and also this is aluminum. We also have brass.
Oh my
gosh. It's going to be a little bit more, but it's very
platinum,
cool.
Gold, silver, and black. Yeah, because then you get the blue and the black and the platinum and silver.
A gold one would be awesome because it has value from the gold and value from the Bitcoin.
There you go, exactly. Yeah, well, I mean, no, not real gold. It's gold colored, right?
Oh,
you're talking about.
I said brass.
Brass.
Okay. gold one.
If it were gold, yes. That's a whole other product. But I love that because then you could have, you know, your life savings and your, you know, smaller denominations for different purposes, different savings for different purposes.
That's right.
You know, Christmas savings or this or that or whatever the heck it is you're saving for. And like you say, different denominations, if you want to short-term savings, long-term savings, however you want to view it.
Yeah.
That's very clever. And also when you want to redeem it, you want to redeem the smallest denomination that would be efficient for what you're doing.
Sure. Yeah.
This is brilliant because, you know, we can create a video that someone can go through, you know, 30 minutes or an hour of, you know, work with a PC and wipe the hard drive and all this technical stuff. Mm-hmm. But, you know, giving this to someone and saying, that's it. You just click and this is the address. Now, this is scannable, but like if I want to if I have this card and I want to use the standard client, do I have to type in the public address?
So the easiest way is if you have a webcam, you can just hold it in and it beeps and then it's in.
Yeah.
We do, the text is on there as a backup so that if you know, you're in a pinch, you don't have a webcam, there's always that fallback, so, you know.
The webcam would scan it and then it would, that's to redeem it.
That's right.
But what if I want to make deposits into it?
Oh, okay.
Oh, then the easiest way is probably with my scanner app on my phone to scan it in and email it to myself, and once I've got it in my address book, it's there forever, and I could just send it to it regularly. I could probably memorize at least the last four or six digits, and I know for sure that's the right one.
In fact, once you buy these, you know, we might even just email you the address.
Yeah, that's a good idea, right?
Right.
Yeah,
you know, you give us your email, and we take one of these sets that has the bank card and then also the payee card, and so we'll email you the address while we mail
that's
it
cool.
to you.
Yeah, because there's nothing that anyone can really do with it except for send your money. track your savings.
God
of course, they could check your balance, but you know, but still, it's a lot less risky than taking it. At least if it's an email that's secure and it's coming straight to you, then you know.
Right. That's not decided, but that's something we could do. And, and also, you have the payee card, so. Even if this is locked away somewhere that's hard to access, you always have that other card you can use.
Right. Or maybe having it emailed to you could be optional for those people who, you know, would have trouble scanning it or something.
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah, that's a brilliant idea. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. We really appreciate you taking the time out of your busy life in the Bitcoin physical manufacturing world.
That's right.
Yeah, it's actually very handy because I was explaining to him, I never thought of actually holding a Bitcoin. But I've explained it to many people, and like, so you can't hold it, you can't touch it. I was just about to ask you that. I was like, I'm very excited to see some Bitcoins, and I can't see them now.
it's such a clever idea.
Yeah, it's great.
Now, are the new models going to look different than these? These prototypes, or are they going to look at all different?
So this prototype is it's a prototype, and the new one we're not going to have a QR of the address. That's because that's already on the payee card, and instead we're increasing the size of the private key, making it even more redundant. And then this is also sort of a rough cut, but the final ones, they're much more precise tooling, so they come out a lot nicer.
About the denominated ones? Are they going to change in appearance at all?
Oh yeah, so this is still the first version that we released a couple months ago, and. We have some changes coming. We have new denominations coming. 0.5 will be the first one. And then we also, down the road a little bit, we'll have new holograms. And just we're incrementing the security, and we're going to try to keep incrementing the security to keep up with.
You better start doing a 0.1.
Yeah,
because
it's
coming. 0.1 is already over a dollar.
and the great thing about our company in general is like, as of recent, we've gotten the production to the point where we can now churn these things out. And so before we had people asking for bulk orders and even just making large orders, and it would take a week before we could fulfill it. But now that we have the production in place, we can really focus on
Another question I just thought of is, you know, so many merchants are accepting Bitcoin now. Mm-hmm. Maybe you haven't had time with all of the everything you are doing, but I wonder if merchants need to be educated about what they look like. Like, just have a visit from somebody to say, look, these are Bitcoins, these are Bitbills, and you know, this is what a physical Bitcoin looks like, and you can literally put this in the extra slot of your cash register and boom, boom, you can accept Bitcoin without any hardware, internet, anything.
Yeah, that's a really good idea.
Yeah, I mean, a food cart without electricity could take Bitcoins for hot dogs and Coke, literally, as long as they're familiar with what they look like any currency, they need to understand what it looks like, and if they're, you know, they trust. How can a merchant actually verify that it's not an artificial, like a counterfeit?
Sure. So counterfeiting, there's a lot of different security aspects of the cards. Counterfeiting is one. And like, we have these security holograms on here.
Mm-hmm.
These can't be replicated. So you can trust that it's from us. It's also, if you get one of these things, the first thing you want to do is check the design, check how it feels, make sure that it's familiar to you.
Mm-hmm.
After that, if you really want to be sure and make sure it's not some kind of excellent counterfeit, you'll check the holograms.
Mm-hmm.
And we use the secure Earth hologram and then this valid secure hologram.
I've got a great idea for you.
Yeah.
I'm always full of ideas. You need to publish like a laminated 8.5x11 how to verify the authenticity of a Bitbill.
That's a
merchants should be given one, and maybe a sample Bitbill or whatever, so that they know how to verify, because everybody knows how to, you know, hold a $100 bill up in the market and all that stuff. They need to know how to recognize a valid one, and it's like, it would also be a good, you know, kind of an excuse to bring up conversation with them and explain, because especially merchants who are already accepting Bitcoin, like, our sponsors, of course, they all take Bitcoin. And more and more, tomorrow, I think it's tomorrow, Friday, we're going to have on the show another restaurant in New York that accepts Bitcoin. So they need to know about this, because they, even if they know about Bitcoin, they might not know about Bitbills, and they certainly need to be able to accept those.
That's right.
Have you run into any counterfeit Bitbills before, or do you have like procedures in place to handle
So we haven't run into any in the wild. We've definitely tasked people with trying their hardest to counterfeit them, and
oh, that's awesome.
They've not been able to, but the next version, we have a lot more security features, and so when you're talking about that chart, it sounds like it'd be great for when we
for the new version.
For the new version, because you know, here the big thing is the hologram. Right. Which is easy enough to tell people about, but in the next version we have some more hidden features that we want to tell people.
Is that going to drive up the cost, or is the fee still going to be the same?
Well, so we're kind of trying to balance. We're ramping up production, which brings down the cost, but we're also ramping up security. So we're hoping fees, we just actually have the fees. So we're hoping we'll be able to keep it at the new lower
level. You cut them in half?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. In Bitcoin terms or dollar terms?
In Bitcoin terms.
Oh, okay.
So,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, people have really asked for lower, from the beginning, they really loved them, but they wanted lower fees, so but now that we have production up, we've been able to do it, and we're hoping to do it again.
Yeah, when Bitcoin was only, you know, 6 cents or whatever.
Well, Bitbills have been around only in the...
Yeah, and then how much was
it's been
Bitcoin
around 2 months
when you launched?
So that was
so only 2 months. It's been a couple
$8.
Of dollars. Yeah.
$8, yeah.
$5 to $8, I think.
Yeah, so but it's still almost doubled, so.
Right.
Yeah,
Somebody's asking if you could print these on recyclable material.
Recyclable material.
It's not something we've worked on yet, because we really want to just make sure we have 100% durability and reliability, but in the future, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's probably a secondary concern when it's money we're talking about.
That's right.
You know, everything else can be recyclable, but money is pretty important.
The aluminum, that's recyclable. The
aluminum, there you go. So. Turn in for a deposit.
Yeah.
You get to, so it's made out of old soda cans or something.
Yeah.
That's cool. Very, very cool.
Yeah.
All right. So what are you gonna come out with next? What's on the drawing board?
So I mentioned a few things. We've got the redemption tool that'll be on the site. Mm-hmm. We've got the lower denomination, the newer version of this, and the bank cards.
Right.
Mm-hmm. A big thing also is these come with payee cards, which are those cards that just have the address on them.
Oh, yeah.
And people really want those that they could just make for a private key they already have. So maybe you already have an address that you use at your restaurant for doing business where people send coins for the meals. You can come around with a card, a metal card that's made just like this, and we'll even let you put your logo on it, but it has a large QR code that people can scan with their
phone. Great.
So after the meal, they just pull this out and they scan it, and then they can send you the
So the server in the restaurant could just have it right there.
That's like, right.
They can hand it with the bill.
Instead of carrying around that credit card terminal on their belt, they can just pull this card out and say, bleep, and they scan it and put it back in their pocket, their holster. Wow, that's very clever.
So we're hoping that's probably in 2 to 3 weeks. We're just working on getting the process down so that you can submit your own address and then also your own image and brand.
Wow. And that'll be a metal card too, so it's... Right?
That's so right. It'll be metal, just like...
Even more durable than anything laminated, plastic, or anything else.
Right.
So just for... You could use it forever.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's very clever.
Very clever.
Cool. Oh my gosh, I'm sure you're not gonna... Your innovation isn't slowing down anytime soon. That's fantastic.
There's a lot of stuff to do with Bitcoins in the real world, so...
Congratulations. So is this taking up all your time now?
Most of it.
Yeah?
Yeah, okay. we've been working hard behind the scenes too. The products are very visible, but there's a lot to do in terms of keeping the company secure and making sure that, you know, we'll be able to keep doing this in 10 years.
Yeah.
So.
And I know we talked about there was a time when you were just overwhelmed with orders and you couldn't fulfill them fast enough.
Right.
And you had so many back ordered. And I know we talked about it, right? And about the idea of just like you had thought of, you were so overwhelmed, you were thinking about just stopping taking orders. And I'm like, I said, no, just tell them it'll take 6 months or whatever it takes. Mm-hmm. And so how did that work out?
It worked well. So we put 3 months on the site just to set the expectations because we weren't sure how many more orders we'd be getting in.
Mm-hmm.
But we've ramped up a ton, and now all the orders that we had back ordered are shipped out.
Boom. So you always promise less than you can deliver. That's exactly what happens. You put 3 months, and now you're up to real time. So as soon as they order, they're shipped right away?
Within 3 days.
Three days.
The time we're looking for. Yeah.
Wow. So like you could get it in a week.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's amazing. That's fantastic.
So.
And are they coming from the U.S.?
That's right. Yeah, it's all shipped out of the U.S.
And you're shipping worldwide?
Yeah, we are.
Wow.
But how many have you shipped? do you think?
We've shipped thousands.
Nice.
In that order. So.
Are they like what countries are like how the proportions?
Yeah. So most of them are United States, but we've also had some large orders. We've had multiple orders in Belgium and in Germany and in France.
Nice.
I won't say the countries we've had single orders from, but there's a lot of those too.
Belgium, Germany, and France. Belgium and what language do they speak in Belgium?
Dutch.
Belgium.
Dutch. I'm not sure.
Isn't it Dutch, maybe?
France, and what was the other country? Germany.
Yeah, Belgium, Germany.
Yeah, cool. So. We're talking about launching a Bitcoin show in all these multiple languages, so it's very interesting where the market is. Because there's no direct way to tell other than there have been studies on the analytics of the Bitcoin.org site to see what percentages of the
audience. I think the Belgians speak French, maybe?
Maybe. Well, it's probably Belgian. I think it's Belgian. It's like a combination of Portuguese and French, something like that, right?
Yeah.
So, anyway, cool. Yeah. Well, it's very exciting. You have to keep us informed for sure of all the new developments as they happen.
That's right.
And we'll be definitely looking forward to it.
Thank you.
And I want a bank card. When can I get one?
Next week.
Next week.
That's right.
Okay. So I'll order it today.
Sounds good. We don't have the order form up yet for the bank cards, but it should be up later this week with the first one shipping out early next week.
How much does a bank card cost?
The price isn't finalized yet, but you know.
But it'll be
competitive.
It'll be in Bitcoins. You only accept Bitcoins.
That's right. It'll be in Bitcoin. We actually were working on accepting dollars too. That's another thing. Mm-hmm. Probably
interesting.
A couple months on that, but it's something we're working
on. So it'd almost be like an exchange.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, actually, one of the people we did not expect to be ordering these things are investors who don't know anything about Bitcoin. Who just they've heard about Bitcoin and they think it's a great investment and they want an easy way to get into it. So they
can
understand
the easiest way. Yeah.
You might need to go higher on denominations too, like 100 Bitcoin.
We might, yeah.
And that's actually interesting, especially bring out the cash option. That's a new way to invest. Mm-hmm. And you don't have to worry about computer security. You don't have to worry about viruses or anything crazy like that.
That's right.
Exactly.
So, it'll be adjusting live with the exchange rate. So you'll just whatever the last trade price is, or thereabout, is what you'll pay for the card.
Wow, cool. And completely off topic, but the official languages of Belgium are Dutch, French, and German.
There you have it. There you have it. You got them all covered. That's great. Well, thank you so much, Doug.
Thank you.
I really appreciate the time.
That's right.
To come. All right. See you guys. See you tomorrow.